This time I'm using the ground beef and ground pork package that I got. It's 2¼ pounds. It's a lot of meat, but I didn't package it and I didn't buy it. So first thing I gotta do is cut up my onion. And this was also from Foodbank, I don't know, a month or so ago. I keep these parts here. They go in my stock whenever I make stock. Here. Give me a bowl to put this in. Now, I gotta brown my onions because they just taste a little bit better in your meatloaf if they've been browned a little bit. So, my skillet going. Just a little bit of butter because I like onions cooked in butter. While those are cooking, I'll come back over here and start mixing everything else up. So, all right, yeah, we got to get this out of my way. Thank you. have to smell it to make sure it's okay. Because it did come from the food bank, and I'm not sure how they handle everything. So, it smells fine. Everything in here is from the food bank, except the spices and the soup mix. No, actually I got soup mix at the church food bank a few weeks ago. The oatmeal came from the senior commodities, eggs and the spices, or whatever you want to call them. Parsley, paprika, and garlic powder came from the grocery store. And I'm not choosy about what color peppers go in here. I got him in here. And parsley. A little bit of paprika. To give it a little bit of smoky flavor. Garlic powder. Yes, I like my garlic powder. Doesn't everybody? Actually, no, not everybody does. A little soup mix. I don't measure anything. I just kind of drop things in there according to what I have. Well, I need a bigger spoon in there. Since I got 2.5 pounds, I'll use a little more oatmeal. Alright. I think that's all I need to put in there. A little bit of milk. I don't have any made up. So this time I'll use something else. Anyway, time to get my hands dirty. Messy. Oops. Okay. Okay, I was gonna mix it, but I think I'll wait. Clean my hands off. Wait for the onions. Decided to go ahead and make up some powdered milk. I use a pint candy jar. This is a funnel I made out of a pop top. And in 1 pint, I put in about half a pint of water, half a cup of milk. I've got it marked. This is the Meyer brand milk. I like it the best because it tastes more like fresh milk when it's made. Usually let the milk fall on its own. Doesn't seem like it's falling the way it usually does, so just kind of encourage it to fall into the water. Stir the onions. I think it's filled as much as it's going to. Yeah, stir it up. That's what I like about the Meyer milk. It just instantly dissolves. Where the commodity powdered milk doesn't. It's a different brand, and it's the Meyer milk I can mix in cold water. The commodity milk has to be mixed in really hot water and then made cold. Well, this one I can get cold tap water and it works fine. Now I've filled it up the rest of the way, and all it needs is a good stir, and there's no lumps at all. Well, except the ones that are clinging to the spatula. Yeah, they're tiny little bumps, but those things eventually dissolve too. And I like a little bit of milk in my meatloaf, so I'm gonna go ahead and put, I don't know, 3 or 4 tablespoons into my meatloaf. That's it until the onions get done. Alright, I got the onions all caramelized. They're ready to go in the meatloaf. Now, get my hands dirty again. Yep, the onions are still hot, but that's okay. They'll cool down a minute. The secret to making a good... Oh, they come out of the soup mix. I was getting ready to throw away my food. It looked like a rock. Yeah. Now, where was I? Oh, yeah. The secret to making a good meatloaf is don't mix it too much. You want everything thoroughly mixed, but you don't want to overwork it because it'll get real tough. Yeah. I thought I had a rock in my meat. That's funny. It was the onion soup mix kind of had a... Oops. Come on in. You see them?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Is that the right ones?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah, it was my son-in-law came to pick up some labels I print for their candles. All right, I think I mixed it enough. It's thoroughly mixed, but not overworked. So, now, since this is supposed to be a loaf, I'll make sure that all the oatmeal's mixed in. Yeah, everything looks good. Let me get my pan. Oh, crap. There we go. Yeah, this is my... I inherited this from my grandma. And I don't think it's real old, but I got it when she passed away. I got another one just like it came from my auntie. Just put it in there. Just kind of make a loaf shape. Leave some room around the sides so that the liquid fat, when it gets hot, it comes out of the loaf. You want a place for it to land around the outside edges. I hope you can see what I'm doing. If you notice, I didn't put no salt in this. I don't cook with salt. Alrighty. I think that's it. Let me wash my hands again. I'm gonna use dish detergent to get rid of the grease. I'm going to put just a little bit of water around the edges. Just like maybe a couple of ounces of water up to about here. And this is a half pint jar. So, put a little bit of water to keep it moist. Pop. Goes into a 350 tabletop oven for about an hour. Alrighty. Okay. Take 350. All right. I think that's it for now. I'll bring you back whenever it gets done. To be just a little thick. Looks like it's done.